let's see what Jim Carrey got to say about Will Smith smacking Chris Rock at the Oscars.
Jim Carrey weighing in on Will Smith's Oscar controversy during a new interview with Gayle King for CBS Morning.
Oh, wow!
I'm not gonna lie, he got smacked like a baby back bitch.
They asked Chris, do you want to file charges? And Chris apparently said no, he did not.
Snitch. Snitch. Snitch.
He doesn't want the hassle. I'd announced this morning that I was suing Will for $200 million. Cause
payday, get money. It's payday, get money. We gonna get that money. We gonna get that money.
That video is gonna be there forever.
Forever, 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 ever, forever, ever.
I'm not gonna lie. I'd fucking sue his ass too.
Jim Carrey was on hand promoting his new movie, Sonic the Hedgehog 2, but yeah, he made it clear how he felt about Will Smith's actions on Sunday night.
You do not have the right to walk up on stage and smack somebody in the face.
Oh, wow!
Because they said words.
Smacked a motherfucker too.
Since Sunday night, the Academy has launched a formal review into Smith's actions on stage, and Will has since issued a statement apologizing to Chris Rock.
Uncle Willie, you didn't have to say sorry. Sticking up for your wife, man, and being a real man, that shit was justified.
Saying in part, quote, I would like to publicly apologize to you, Chris.
I wanna say I'm sorry for the things I've done, and I try and be stronger in this life I chose, but I want you to know.
I was out of line and I was wrong. I was embarrassed and my actions were not indicative of the man I want to be. There is no place for violence. In a world of love and kindness. On Sunday, Extra spoke to many stars who also weighed in on Will's behavior.
You watched the show, I'm sure you saw the moment everyone is talking about between Chris and Will. Your thoughts?
I don't condone violence.
I don't condone violence.
I just don't see any reason for it.
He said it in his vows, until death do us part.
I do know
if you get her a Valium, she'll quietly go away.
That if you can have any comedian and the rest of the show, everyone was being ridiculed in some way.
Right.
I don't give a fucking fuck. That means everybody getting slapped.
The only difference was, I think if you're a celebrity and you're in there, you know that's going to happen.
Sure.
Maybe, you know, this was his wife, so it was different.
Right. Again.
But I'm not sure you run up and punch someone in the face.
He didn't punch him, he slapped him like a baby back bitch.
If you remember, Chris hosted the Oscars.
Yes.
And brilliantly. I mean, I just remember it was just kind of like
this really awesome, insane fucking moment.
Better than anyone.
Yeah.
And Chris is a
idiot for talking about another man's wife.
A genius comic that has been doing it for many, many decades, and the premise being that these indeed are jokes.
Some people don't find it fucking funny.
Do you think as a comedian, though, you should ever worry about needing to be censored?
You know, I think anytime
I forget what I'm gonna say.
You know, Chris is one of those comics that he and Chappelle are the goats. And they're like the youngest, oldest comics in the world.
They're the youngest, oldest comics in the world. How are they young and old at the same time?
Been doing it since they were kids. And I think, you know, the contract you set up with the audience is that these are indeed jokes and we have to embrace our freedom of speech.
We could save that.
That was a way to insult a woman,
her sexuality, her physique. It was a way to call a woman a homosexual, basically.
Oh, I didn't hear him call her a homosexual.
And she's sitting right next to her. It was like that. I remember that in school, that they would do that to people, you know. It's kind of messed up.
It's super messed up. He'd talk about another man's wife like that.
Oh, wow.
Thank you guys so much for watching. Comment, like, subscribe, share. Hit that bell to get notified. More videos from DMBZ Creations to come. Y'all look out for them. I look forward to seeing y'all again. Peace.